social universe, where you learn the secrets of the social media, and in many cases, the secrets of the universe itself. We always love to give a little bit of universal knowledge that may help in one way or another. The aspects of really getting to know someone, not just having surface relationships on Facebook, but actually treating it in a way that creates real relationships. So, but first, in this segment, we want to talk about just the outreach, the mm-hmm. getting to know people in mass a little bit. So social media is a little bit more mass communication, but then it becomes also interpersonal communication. Mm-hmm. So you want to use it in both ways. In the social media, what would you say are some of the strengths and weaknesses of your use of the social media? I mean, you are a talk show host yourself, and mm-hmm. what are some of your favorite uses of the social media?
Well, some of my favorite uses of the social media would probably be, you know, the free advertising that you can get from it. Mm-hmm. Just creating kind of a network yourself for people who have personal interests just like you, or who, you know, want to get to know you better. I think that it's really great that not only can you keep a lasting connection, you know, from state to state, because sometimes it could be hard from letters, but now that we have internet, it's just the newest thing, especially from doing emails so long. Now we can do it all together, especially with statuses, updating everybody on what we're doing. I just think it's kind of a more fun way to really establish how we live our daily lives. But at the same time, I feel like the weakness of it would probably be how time-consuming it could be, because sometimes you get so caught up in posting so many different things, and you look at the time, and you're like, wow, an hour just went by, and I didn't even know I was doing that. But I really think it's more positive than negative, because there's so much good that can come from it.
Absolutely. Which social media platforms do you like the most? I mean, I think I'm hearing Facebook a lot, so
yes.
Probably Facebook is your favorite.
Facebook would probably be my favorite. I've tried different things. I think Twitter's pretty cool as well. So I've been kind of dabbling in Twitter myself, and I think that Facebook would probably be my favorite by far, though, because I feel like there's everything. You can get little apps that can help you with different things, but more importantly, it's easier to connect with friends, and also the statuses are really great, and also the message communication, so you can talk to people personally, or you can talk to them on, you know, like comment level, where you can share it with everybody.
It's very true. One of the things that I really like about the Facebook profile is it has the chat function, so that's where the interpersonal communication comes in. But that doesn't exist on a Facebook fan page.
Mm-hmm.
Mark Zuckerberg actually took that away from businesses on purpose because he felt that it was too powerful,
mm-hmm.
Too invasive, which is almost a contradiction in terms. Social media is all about the invasion of personal privacy.
Mm-hmm.
And from an advertising standpoint, we love that. From a
yes.
personal standpoint, from a parental standpoint, I don't even let my boys get on Facebook, frankly. They don't have a profile. I don't allow them in
uh-huh.
there. The downsides of the social media are absolute violation of privacy.
Yes.
So from a children's perspective, a little bit of a rough concept. One of my charities that I very get involved in is a little bit hardcore. It's slavery. So
mm-hmm.
it has human slavery,
mm-hmm.
which has a lot to do with the human enslavement of women.
Mm-hmm.
This is a family show, so I will
mm-hmm.
not talk about all the different ways
mm-hmm.
that enslavement occurs, but a lot of that begins in Facebook, where
mm-hmm.
they recruit, they tell somebody to, you know, meet them somewhere, and then they're literally sold into slavery on the spot.
Mm-hmm.
So it can be a little bit crazy.
Yes.
And
mm-hmm.
so we always want, if you have children out there,
mm-hmm.
be a little bit, I would warn you to be very, very careful about the use of Facebook, and to, if you're going to allow your children to be on Facebook, to make sure that they understand that everybody
mm-hmm.
isn't always who they say they are.
Yeah, I totally get where you're coming from, because I think that's kind of where the boundary line is written across, because really you have to be careful with the social network, because it can be a really good thing and it can be really awesome to connect with people, but you just got to make sure that you're connecting with the right people and you know them on a personal level, and you're not just giving out your information, which I feel very strongly about, because I know a lot of people, you know, sometimes they'll reveal too much information on Facebook, and that can be a bad thing sometimes. So I really think that if you do decide to do Facebook, like you had mentioned, really be aware of your surroundings, but also if the parents, they should check your Facebook. I know it sounds weird, you're like, well, sounds a little weird, right? But I feel like you have more protection that way, and it's not like they're snooping or anything, it's just that they're looking out for you and what you're putting out there.
And remember that if there's any children listening to that, and if you have children, make sure you explain to them that there are people way worse than the parent that is that are observing what's going on the social media. And so, yeah, thank you for kind of setting the example of allowing parents to kind of look in on what's going on your social media, so that they can recognize the dangers. But as long as people don't abuse Facebook, it's a wonderful thing.
Okay.
It's a very social thing. It allows people to interact. And then also one of the warnings that I would give about social media is that it's addictive, as you're saying. But if it ever replaces the real personal interaction, for example, the big joke is that high schools are much more calm now because everybody just sits in the hallways and texts and doesn't even talk to each other.
Yeah.
even if they're sitting right next to each other, they're just texting. That's more of a joke than anything. But in many cases, it's also true. But that human interaction is still what people desire, people are looking for. Do you have any creative uses of the social media from a personal branding standpoint that you would want to share with people?
Yeah, of course. Well, other than Facebook, I use the fan pages a lot, which is actually going back into Facebook. But I find that it's a good way to really share your personal interests and just people have you to be, I guess, liked, as the term would be, on Facebook. That way they can really follow what you're doing and really see what you do on a daily basis, or even when you post or you go to events. But leaning towards out of Facebook, I would say that the different networking sites, such as making your own website. I know I have my own website. It's officialmattyrose.com. And with that, I feel people can check more about me, you know, just learning about more who I am, what my interests are, and what I'm up to, but also just to really see everything of what I do and what it consists of. So I really think that having that advertising aspect is a really neat thing to discover.
Yeah, I would say so too. And then somebody who is at your level, who would be the term I would want to use, that you're starting to connect in the adult world from the standpoint of you're a talk show host, and so you're a lot of your business connections, you're making business connections at a very early age. So I commend you for that.
Thank you.
I would definitely encourage you to start using LinkedIn, create a LinkedIn account, and you put that resume down, and you would be surprised how many very professional relationships you would be able to connect with, ways to get found, in listening to a couple of your talk shows, you have aspirations to be an entertainment attorney.
Yes.
it doesn't hurt to start reaching out and making those connections. You never know where. Now, when we come back from the break, we are going to talk more about what your in your personal life, where what your goals and your dreams are, but obviously being an entertainment attorney would be one of them. But you might as well start making connections now. In media, that's the entertainment side, but then law firms, you know, internships may come up. You have work study options that you might take advantage of in your junior, senior year, things of that nature. So those are things that you would be surprised how easily they surface. But it's like Facebook in slow motion.
Yes.
Okay? Because some, you know, business people get a little bit busy. 3 months later, they finally realize, oh yeah, LinkedIn. So they sit down and respond to 200 people at once. And then they may not look at it again for 3 months. So it's very much in slow motion, and so it's something that you might get take 3 or 4 years to do something you might do in a year in Facebook. But it's much more powerful because of pre-qualified connections. So these are just thank you for entering into potentially what the new generation thinks.
Yeah,
and
of course.
I know that you're one person out of many, but it's always nice to hear what the new generation thinks. Do you have any overarching kernels of knowledge before we go to break about social media that you would want to share with the audience?
Well, I definitely think with social media, like you mentioned, which is really great to touch on as well as a topic, is that, you know, you can make really good long-lasting connections over the social media, especially if you're careful and you actually, you know, give them the appropriate information and you get to know them, and it's really good and it's really powerful, especially getting to do the opportunities, whether like it's a small event in your community, maybe you get to do something that you didn't get to do before, maybe that's performing, or maybe you get to see a radio station and then you feel really passionate about that. So I think that you can learn a lot from social media, but at the same time you can really establish your aspirations and dreams and really make something out of it.
I think so as well. And so if any of you get a chance to meet Maddie, probably the best place if you ever wanted to get a chance to meet her, go to the fundraisers and, and make some donations.
That would be nice. Yeah, definitely.
So when we come back from the break, we'll talk a little bit about what you want to do in the years to come. Mm-hmm. And so we thank everyone for tuning in during this segment, and we're going to go to break. When we return, we'll be talking with Maddie Rose further about the future impact that she's going to have here in the Arizona and the U.S.
Mm-hmm.